everyone, I'm Zach, and welcome back to another HitFilm tutorial. Today I'll be showing you how to create a customizable vortex or wormhole effect. This effect can be anything from a Doctor Who-style time vortex to a Star Wars-style hyperspace tunnel. We will model the 3D vortex in Blender and will then texture it in HitFilm. Express users will need the 3D model add-on. Let's hop over to Blender to create a 3D model for our vortex. Delete everything in the default scene and press Shift A to add in a cylinder object. Increase the depth to be the length of your tunnel. Then disable the caps as we don't need the ends to be filled in. I'll rotate the object so it's facing the right way. If all you need is a straight tunnel like you'd see in a Star Wars hyperspace effect, this model is pretty much done. We'll be creating the illusion of movement by animating the textures in HitFilm, so we don't have to model a huge tunnel for our camera to fly through. Press 1 on the numpad to go to front view, then create a new camera. Press 0 on the numpad to look through the camera, then adjust the camera's focal length. I decided to use a wider angle lens, which will make the movement seem faster and the tunnel seem longer. Select the cylinder, then from the right click menu, choose Shade Smooth, then press Tab to go into Edit Mode. Make sure everything is selected, and flip the normals. This makes the inside of the cylinder the side that will render properly. Go over to the UV editing workspace. The cylinder object comes already UV unwrapped, but we want to rotate the UVs 90 degrees. Press R, type 90, then hit Enter. This is to take better advantage of our texture resolution in HitFilm, since it will have a wider aspect ratio instead of being square. Now is also a good time to set your project resolution and frame rate. I'm going for a more chaotic Doctor Who style vortex, so there's a few more steps to add the twists and turns. In Edit Mode, hit Ctrl R and type in a number to add many loop cuts to divide up the cylinder. We need this extra geometry so we can bend and warp the object. Back in Object Mode, add a simple Deform modifier and set it to Bend. Duplicate the modifier and select the other axis. Playing with the angle values will bend our tunnel in different directions. Set the angle values to 0, then insert an animation keyframe for both modifiers. We won't be animating these values by hand. Instead, we can apply a noise modifier to add some random variation. Go to the animation workspace and make this panel into a graph editor. Hit N to show more options. Add the noise modifier, then adjust the settings to your liking. I increase the scale and strength to make slower, larger movements. Click this button to copy the modifier, then paste it on the other animated value. Change the offset settings so they don't match. If you want your vortex to have some 3D detail in addition to the 2D textures we'll add later, you can apply a displacement modifier to the object. Create a new texture for the displacement and set the type to clouds. Adjust the strength of the modifier and smooth it out by adding a subdivision surface modifier. Drag these modifiers up so they come before the deform modifiers. To make the displacement move, add a new empty object and animate its position along the y-axis. Set the keyframe interpolation to linear. On the displacement modifier, set the coordinates to object and select the empty. If you look through our camera inside the tunnel, you can see the effect we've created. The camera is stationary, but it looks like we are moving. Let's export this 3D scene so we can work with it in HitFilm. There's a tutorial linked in the card on screen showing how to install the Blender to HitFilm exporter script. This allows us to export the camera from Blender to a HitFilm composite shot. Next, export the cylinder object as an OBJ 3D model. Then export the animation as an Alembic file. Now that we have a base model for our vortex, let's bring it into HitFilm to add all the cool textures and details. Start by importing the HitFilm composite shot we exported from Blender. Then import the OBJ model file. Enable Material Override for the diffuse map, so we can use the HitFilm layer as the texture. Also make sure that the diffuse color is fully white, so our textures won't be darkened. In the advanced options, disable center anchor point and auto normalize scale. This ensures that the 3D model will line up with the camera from Blender. Dragging the model onto the timeline, it lines up on the first frame, but it isn't animated. Import the Alembic animation file and drag it onto the model's animation slot. Now everything is looking like it did in Blender, so we can move on to setting up the textures. Add a new composite shot and increase the dimension so the texture will be more detailed and less blurry. I'll make mine 4096 by 2160, since that's the maximum resolution for Express users. Create a new plane layer, then apply the fractal noise effect. To make it look like we are flying through the vortex, the noise pattern will be animated to move across the screen. Since we'll be layering up many fractal noise effects, we shouldn't animate the noise's position value, because if we needed to change the speed, we'd have to change the keyframes on all the effects. Instead, let's animate a point layer's position and reference that on the noise effects. Animate the point to move from left to right if you want to be moving forward through the vortex. Drag this texture comp into the main comp and hide it. Then select it as the cylinder model's diffuse map in the override materials controls. And now it looks like we are traveling through the vortex. Since I animated the displacement in Blender, I'll match my texture animation speed to that. We currently have an ugly seam running down our tunnel, so let's fix that. Make the texture and point into their own comp. Move the layer half of the comp's height down. Then duplicate it and control-click the position value to move it up. Make one more duplicate, reset its position, then add a mask covering the seam down the middle and feather it out. Now our texture wraps seamlessly around our cylinder. With everything set up and ready to go, we can now have some fun dialing in the look of our vortex. Adjust the type, colors, exposure, offset, scale, and axis scales of the fractal noise. Duplicate the fractal noise effect, change the blend mode, and change the other settings again. To create the look shown at the beginning of the video, I started with some dark gray clouds, then added some brighter brown clouds and some pale blue energy. I then added some small bright spots of blue, red, and magenta. Make sure to change the seed for these layers so they don't overlap. I also added some small bright star streaks by adjusting the axis scale setting to stretch out the noise. To give the appearance of motion blur, add an angle blur effect. Back in our main comp, this vortex is looking pretty good, but we can make it look even better. Because my model itself has animation, I can enable motion blur on the model layer. Use color correction effects like curves to dial in the brightness, contrast, and color of your vortex. If you want a bright light at the end of your vortex, add a white plane layer below the model layer. You can then enhance the bright spots of the vortex by using glow effects. I chose to apply the glows to a grade layer so it would bleed over the bright end of the tunnel. If it's now too bright, you can use a fill color effect to make the background plane a gray color instead of pure white. On a new grade layer, I chose to add a fast shake effect to add some more movement and make the shot more intense. Finally, let's add even more detail and interest to this shot with some lens dirt. I'll use a real lens dirt texture to make it more realistic. You now have a fully customizable vortex effect. Try playing around with different textures to create totally different looks, like the Star Wars style hyperspace tunnel. Take it to the next level by adding a 3D model of a spaceship. The TARDIS 3D model used in the opening shot was created by Tony C, and he's got some great Doctor Who content created with HitFilm, as well as some HitFilm tutorials on his YouTube channel linked in the description. Check out this other tutorial to learn more about 3D models in HitFilm. Leave a comment with any questions or suggestions, and hit the like button if you learned something new. Remember to subscribe for more tutorials like this. See you next time!